just an example of water jet problem. We'll see water jet problem in detail. We'll see what is that problem. We'll see what is the use of production systems, and we'll see how the production systems are used to solve that problem. Okay. So for solving a problem, first of all, we should understand what the problem is. Okay. So we can check what the problem is at first. We are provided with two jugs. Okay. There are two jugs. The first jug is a 4-gallon jug. Next jug is a 3-gallon jug. We have two different jugs with us. One jug is a 3-gallon jug. Another jug is a 4-gallon jug. That gallon is a capacity value, capacity measurement. Okay, like liter or something like that. One jar can hold 3 gallons of water. Another one can hold 4 gallons of water. Okay. And there is no other measuring equipment available, and the jugs do not have any kind of marking on them. That means the jugs are not marked with any type of measurements, and we do not possess any measuring equipments as well. And what we have to do is, we can pour in and out any amount of water at any stage. The problem is that we have to fill the 4-gallon jug with exactly 2 gallons of water. This is the problem. We have to fill 4-gallon jug with 2 gallons of water. Okay. And the only thing that we have to do this is the two jugs only. We do not have any other equipments to do this, and we can pour in and out any amount of water at any stage. As there is no exact marking, we have to, at the final stage, we should have exactly 2 gallons of water in the 4-gallon jug. So how we can solve this problem? And before solving, we have to check the initial stage. In the initial stage, both jugs are empty. At the initial state, in both jugs, there is no amount of water. It is completely empty. So this is the initial stage. Okay, so as a step one, this is the initial stage. This is a 4-gallon jug and this is a 3-gallon jug. And I'm representing the 4-gallon jug with a variable X and representing the 3-gallon jug with a variable Y. So initial value of X and Y is 0. Okay, so we represent the jugs using a tuple X, Y. Let X denote the 4-gallon jug and Y denote the 3-gallon jug. And we have to mention these three points before executing or before giving the solution or before explaining any of the AI problems. The first point is initial state. As an initial state, we have X is equal to 0 and Y is equal to 0 here, because 3-gallon jug and 4-gallon jug is empty in the initial state, and this is given in your problem itself. And the next point is the goal state. Goal state means a final condition. The final condition when which we can stop the processing, or which means the problem is solved. That means the 4-gallon jug, which is denoted by the variable X, should hold exactly the value 2. And the value of Y is not defined. It can be anything. It can be empty, it can be full, or it can be any value. The main point that we are focused on is X should have exactly 2 gallons of water. The next point that we are discussing is a production system. Production system means the set of rules to solve the water jug problem here. And we'll see the production system. This is the AI production system given in the water jug problem. So we'll see each and every rule in detail. So this is the initial state, that is X is equal to 4-gallon jug and Y is equal to 3-gallon jug, where X and Y is completely empty. This is the initial state. And what are the maximum possible possibilities here? Let's think about that. Okay. Possible possibilities means what all things that we can do here. Number one, we can fill this jug completely. That's one possibility. Number two, we can fill this jug completely. That means we can fill 4-gallon jug completely. That's one possibility. We can fill 3-gallon jug completely. That's another possibility. And what's the next possibility? Next possibility is that we can suppose that there is some amount of water in these two jugs. Okay, we are pouring some water outside from 4-gallon jug. That's another situation. We are pouring some water from 3-gallon jug. That's another situation. Okay, and what's another possibility? These two jugs have some water. We are emptying this jug, and that means we are pouring water, full water from this jug. We are pouring full water from this jug as well. Like Likewise, there are many different combination or many different possibilities, and according to these possibilities, we are trying to solve this problem, or we are trying to write the rules, or we are focusing on, when we are focusing on the production system, how we can represent this technique. That's what we are talking about. So think about the first possibility. The first possibility is that this jug is already empty. We can fill it with water. Okay, fill it with any amount of water. So when we are filling completely, this jug will hold what? Exactly 4 gallons of water, right? So if you have to pour water to this jug, the first criteria is that this jug should not be filled, right? ഈ ജഗിൽ വെള്ളം ഒഴിക്കാൻ കുറച്ച് സ്പേസ് എങ്കിലും വേണം, വേണ്ടേ? സോ ഇവിടെ ഫുൾ അമൗണ്ട് ഓഫ് വാട്ടർ ഫിൽഡ് ആയിട്ടിരുന്നാൽ ദാറ്റ് ഡസ് നോട്ട് മീൻ ദാറ്റ് അവിടെ നമ്മൾ ഈ പറഞ്ഞ സിറ്റുവേഷനിൽ ഒരു മീനിങ് ഇല്ല. വി ആർ ഗോയിങ് ടു ഫിൽ ദിസ് ജഗ് കംപ്ലീറ്റ്ലി വിത്ത് വാട്ടർ. സോ ഇതിൽ എത്രയെങ്കിലും കുറച്ചെങ്കിലും വെള്ളം വേണം, വെദർ ഹാഫ് ഓർ എ ക്വാർട്ടർ ഓർ സം അമൗണ്ട് ഓർ 90% വാട്ടർ. ഓക്കെ, ഇറ്റ് ഷുഡ് ബി ലെസ് ദാൻ 4, ദാറ്റ്സ് എ ക്രൈറ്റീരിയ. സോ ലെസ് ദാൻ 4 ആണെങ്കിൽ വി ക്യാൻ പോർ water and fill it, that action will be taken place successfully. And the same comes to this case, we are trying to fill the 3-gallon jug. That means 3-gallon jug il korchu vellam 3-gallon ilum korava irikanam engile namukku idilekku endu cheyan pattullu vellam olichu adine fill cheyan pattullu. And when we are moving on to the formation of the rules, take the first rule. This is the initial state or the situation, that is xy. We have x and y. If you have to fill the 4-gallon jug, what is the condition? The value of x should be less than 4. Then only you can fill that. Otherwise, it is not filling. It's already actually filled if it is 4. Okay. So, if it is less than 4, you can pour water to it and you can make it completely 4. Okay. So, if you are applying the action or if you are filling value to that jug, the final state will be like this. That means the 4-gallon jug will exactly contain 4 and the value of y is not mentioned here. Okay. And coming to the next situation, that is filling the 3-gallon jug with water. What does that mean? 3-gallon jug is not completely filled now. Okay. This has some amount of water less than 3 here and we are pouring water to it and we are making it 3. So the same condition comes up here. If value of y, that means 3-gallon jug, less than 3, then we can pour water into it and the final state will be, final state means the state after the action will be, the 3-gallon jug will be full. That means the value here will be 3 and we are not bothering about the x value. Whatever it is, it will stay as it is. Okay, and that's next possibility. Moving on to the next point, the next thing that we can do is, there is some amount of water here, we can pour water out of this jug, not completely out, we are pouring some amount of water and that amount is not already given. So pouring some amount of water from this jug, the initial condition should be obviously it should have some amount of water, right? So the water level in this jug should be greater than 0. That is a initial condition. So look at this. If x value is greater than 0, that means there is some value here, right? And then we can pour some amount of water from that jug. That means this some amount is not actually mentioned, so we are labeling it as a variable d. So from x, that is the already existing value or the already existing water level, from that already existing water level some amount of water is poured out, that means minus d, and y will stay as it is. That is, it is 3-gallon jug. The same comes to the case of 3-gallon jug. There is some amount of water in 3-gallon jug and we are pouring some amount of water from this jug to outside. So what should be the initial condition? Initial condition is that the 3-gallon jug should contain some amount of water, right? So the value water level should be greater than 0. If it is greater than 0, the x will stay as it is. We are thinking about the 3-gallon jug. From the already existing water level, that is y, we are pouring some amount of water outside. That means minus d, and that d is not defined, it can be any value, right? So moving on to the next situation, that is emptying 4-gallon jug. That's another situation. There is some amount of water here and I am not pouring some out, I am pouring the full water to the outside. That means I am emptying this jug. So emptying 4-gallon jug is also having the condition that the 4 gallon jug should have some water. That means the water level should be greater than zero. And if it is greater than zero, when I am pouring the full amount of water to outside, the x value will become zero and y will stay as it is, because I am not doing anything to the 3 gallon jug. The next possibility is that I am pouring full amount of water outside from the 3 gallon jug, and the same concept comes up to the case of 3 gallon jug. That means the 3 gallon jug water level is greater than zero, and if it is greater than zero, I can fill pour the full amount of water to the outside or to the ground. And if I am pouring the full amount of water to outside, then the y value will become zero and x will stay as it is. Okay. Now coming to the next possibility, that is pouring water from 3 gallon jug into 4 gallon jug. That means we are pouring or trying to pour water from 3 gallon jug to 4 gallon jug. And what is the condition? Until 4 gallon jug is full. So there is some amount of water in 4 gallon jug. That's the initial condition. Okay. So some amount of water is poured from this jug to this jug, and after filling, it will be completely filled. So after the action, the 4 gallon jug will exactly contain 4 gallons of water. So I am pouring some amount of water from this jug to this, and the 4 gallon jug has been getting full. So for this action, let us check the preconditions. There are two preconditions given here. What are the preconditions for this action? The first precondition is that y should be greater than zero. That means for pouring water from 3 gallon jug to 4 gallon jug, the 3 gallon jug should contain some amount of water which is not zero. So it should not be empty. That's the one condition. And what's the next condition? The next condition is that x value plus y value should be greater than or equal to 4. Why that has been applied? So let us check about that particular precondition. Suppose the 4 gallon jug have 2 gallons of water now, okay, and the 3 gallon jug have 1 gallon of water now. Okay, I think it's clear. The 4 gallon jug have 2 gallons of water now, and the 3 gallon jug have 1 amount of water. That means 1 gallon of water. Take this situation. I am pouring water from this jug to this. So the first condition is satisfied. That means y value is greater than 0. That means it contains some amount of water. And if I am pouring the full water to this jar, whether it will be full? No, because 2 plus 1, it is 3. So even if I am pouring the full amount of water from this jug to this jug, it will be altogether 2 plus 1 is equal to 3 gallons of water. And the 4 gallon jug is still having an empty space. It is full like this. It is not completely filled. Right. So for filling this jug, the sum of this water levels should be at least 4. Otherwise, greater than 4. Then only you can pour water from this jug to this, and it will be filled. So I hope it's clear. Okay. And now check about the next possibility, that is pour water from the 4 gallon jug to 3 gallon jug until 3 gallon jug is full. The same situation is there. So before moving on to that, I have forgotten to mention about the situation after the presenting. That means the final state. Okay. That means if I am pouring value from 3 gallon jug to 4 gallon jug, what will be the final state? The 4 gallon jug will be having exactly 4 gallons of water. That's the final state. And what will be the measurement of water in 3 gallon jug? So the final state can be explained as x value will be equal to 4, that we already have understood. That means the purpose of this is we are going to fill the 4 gallon jug completely with water. So when we are pouring water from this jug to this jug and all the given two criteria are satisfied, this jug value will be filled. That means it will be 4 actually. And what will be the value of y? So how can we get it? So the already existing value level in the second jug is y. Okay. And the amount of water that I have poured from this jug to the 4 gallon jug can be obtained by 4, that means the full value in jack, this jack, minus the initial value of that jack, that is x. So 4 minus x is the value of the water that is being poured from this to this. So if we subtract this value from the initial y value, okay, this value is subtracted from the initial y value, we'll get the final result. That means the current existing water level in the 3-gallon jug will be obtained. So the y will be is equal to y minus 4 minus x. Okay. And the same comes to the case of the next option, that is pouring water from 4-gallon jug to 3-gallon jug. This is another situation. Until the 3-gallon jug is fully. The same state comes up here. The same situations that we have done in the case of 4-gallon jug is repeated in the case of 3-gallon jug. And the value of the variables will be only the changing values. Okay. So if we are pouring from water from the 4-gallon jug to the 3-gallon jug, what will be the situations or what will be the preconditions? The 4-gallon jug should contain at least some amount of water, and the value of the 3-gallon jug and 4-gallon jug combined together should be greater than or equal to 3. That means at least the combination value should be 3. Okay. And if we pour value from this jug to this jug, what will be the final situation? The final situation is the y value. That means the 3-gallon jug will be full and it will be having exactly 3 gallons of water. And what will be the existing value in this jug? It will be already the initial value of x minus 3 minus y. The same situation that I have mentioned in the rule 7. Now focus on the next rule or the next situation, that is pouring all water from 3-gallon jug to 4-gallon jug. Y എന്നുള്ള value, that means 3-gallon jug ൽ നിന്ന് 4-gallon jug ലേക്ക് വെള്ളം ഒഴിക്കുന്നു, ഇതിലുള്ള complete waterഉം ഇതിലേക്ക് ഒഴിക്കുന്നു. Until this is full എന്നുള്ള ഒരു കണ്ടീഷൻ അല്ല, we are pouring all the water from 3-gallon jug to 4-gallon jug, and we are not checking that whether it is full or it is quarter or it is half, that is not considered. ഇതിലുള്ള full amount of water നമ്മൾ ഇതിലേക്ക് ഒഴിക്കുന്നു. So we are checking the preconditions at first. What will be the precondition? Initial precondition will be the same. That means y should contain at least some amount of water. That means a 3-gallon jug should contain at least some amount of water. എങ്കിലേ ഇവിടെ നിങ്ങോട്ട് വെള്ളം ഒഴിക്കാൻ പറ്റുള്ളൂ. സോ വൺ കണ്ടീഷൻ ഇസ് ആസ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് റൂൾ 7 ൽ പറഞ്ഞ അതേ സിറ്റുവേഷൻ ആണ് വരുന്നത്. വൈ വാല്യൂ ഷുഡ് ബി ഗ്രേറ്റർ ദാൻ 0. ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദിസ് കണ്ടീഷൻ? ലെറ്റ് എസ് ചെക്ക് അബൌട്ട് ഇറ്റ്. ദി അനദർ വൺ പ്രീ കണ്ടീഷൻ ഇസ് ദാറ്റ് എക്സ് പ്ലസ് വൈ ഷുഡ് ബി ലെസ് ദാൻ ഓർ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു 4. വൈ ദാറ്റ് കംസ് അപ്പ്? സപ്പോസ് ദ 4-ഗ്യാലൻ ജഗ് ഹാവ് 3 ഗ്യാലൻസ് ഓഫ് വാട്ടർ ആൻഡ് ദ 3-ഗ്യാലൻ ജഗ് ഹാവ് 2 ഗ്യാലൻസ് ഓഫ് വാട്ടർ. Then what will be the x plus y value? What is the x plus y value? X plus y value will be is equal to 5, right? 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. And what is the maximum possible capacity of this jug? It is 4. That means if we are pouring full amount of water from 3-gallon jug to this jug, there will be a overflow. That means 1 gallon of water will be overflowed out. Therefore, when we are adding the two water levels together, it should be at most 4. Okay, maximum value should be 4 or less than 4. It should never be greater than 4. Okay, I think it's clear. And what will be the state after this action? That means I am pouring full amount of water from 3-gallon jug to 4-gallon jug. Obviously, when I am pouring full amount of water this from 3-gallon jug to 4-gallon jug, the 3-gallon jug will be empty and the value of the water level will be 0. And what will be the water level here? The water level here will be already existing x value plus the water level in the 3-gallon jug, and that is being denoted with the variable y. So this will have a water level of x plus y, okay, and the 3-gallon jug will be having a water level of 0. And rule 10, that is pouring all water from 4-gallon jug to 3-gallon jug, the same thing that we have defined now will happen in reverse. Okay, I think all the rules are clear to you. Now moving on to the solution of this problem. How we can solve the problem? The initial state is x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0. My goal is I have to fill this jug with exactly the half, that means 2 gallons of water. How that can be possible? So let's check about the solution. So I am explaining the solution to you. That is, I am first in the step 2, I am filling what? The second jug, that means the 3 gallon jug completely. So fill 3 gallon jug with water. This is done by picking a rule from the production system, and that was rule 2. Then Y value became 3. I think it's clear. And in the next step, step 3, I have poured the water from this jug to the 4 gallon jug. That means I have poured the full of water, the full amount of water from 3 gallon jug to 4 gallon jug. What was the rule? The rule number 9. And in the next step, step 4, I have again filled this jug. That means I have filled the jug, 3 gallon jug completely. And that is according to rule 2 again. Okay, and in the step 4, what I have done? In the step 5, I have done is pour water from 3 gallon jug into 4 gallon jug until 4 gallon jug is full. So now this jug is having 3 gallons of water and this jug is having 3 gallons of water. I have applied rule 7, and from this jug I have poured some amount of water to 4 gallon jug until the 4 gallon jug is empty. Then what happened? X value became 4 and Y value became 2. Now in the next step, what I have done is emptying 4 gallon jug according to rule 5. So I have poured out full amount of water from 4 gallon jug to the ground. Now in the final state, this jug had 2 gallons of water. I have filled, or I have poured water from 3 gallon jug to 4 gallon jug. Okay, according to rule 2, and X value became 2. So when X value becomes 2, that means we have achieved the goal state. So if you are checking the solution as a table, we'll get like this. We have applied in the initial state, it was 0, 0. And after after applying 6 different rules, or the 6 sequences of actions, we have got the 4 gallon jug content as 2. And whenever this value gets 2, that is the goal state, and we have stopped. That means we have got the solution. So this is a flow. Initially it both values are 0, 0. We have applied rule number 2 and it became 0, 3. After application of rule number 9, it became 3, 0. After application of rule number 2 again, it became 3 will not be changed. This value will be filled. After applying rule 7, what we have done is we have poured some amount of water from this jug to this, and it became 2 and this became 4. And then we have poured the full amount of water from 4 gallon jug to the ground. That means according to rule number 5, this became 0 and this stayed as it is. And in the final state, we have applied rule number 9. That means we have poured the full water from 3 gallon jug to 4 gallon jug, and this became 0 and this became 2. And we have received the final state. Okay, this is the goal state, and we have found the solution. So this is all about the production systems and the solution of water jug problem, and how a production system is being used, or how a production system is being formed to solve a problem. Okay, I think it is clear. Thank you.